All of calculus is based on the idea of a limit. In fact, the six big ideas of calculus that I call the six pillars, the very first one is close is good enough, the idea of doing approximations and then homing in on an answer. So if we're going to do calculus with functions of several variables, we have to understand what is the limit of a function of several variables. And to do that, it's a good idea to go back and review what we meant by limits for ordinary functions with one input and one output, and for vector-valued functions with one input and several outputs. So for ordinary functions, the definition of a limit was this. When we say the limit as x approaches a of f of x is L, what we're saying is that whenever the input is really, really, really close to A, the output is really, really, really close to L. So whenever x is close to A, but not equal to A, f of x is close to L. Now sometimes people use the word approaches for this. They say, as x approaches A, f of x approaches L. But approaches is just another word for gets really close to. So let's stick with the term close to. Now if we want to make this precise, we have to say how close is close. You tell me how close to L you want to be. That's a number called epsilon. And I'll tell you how close to A you have to be to make that happen. So the precise definition is no matter what value of epsilon you give, that's how close you want f of x to be to L. There's a number delta, that's how close x has to be to A, such that f of x is within epsilon of L whenever x is within delta of A, but not equal to A. So the absolute value of x minus A is less than delta, but bigger than zero. Now, things don't get much different when we talk about functions of several variables. It's the same definition, the limit as x approaches a of f of x equals L just means whenever x is close to a, only now x and a are vectors, f of x is close to L. And so we can put that also in terms of epsilons and deltas, that whenever the distance between x and a is positive but less than delta, the distance between f of x and L is f of x, not f of t. Distance between f of x and L is less than epsilon. So let's do an easy example. Let's take the function f of x equals x times y squared, and we ask, what's the limit as x of y approaches 2, 3? You know, the input is a pair xy, and that approaches a particular pair, 2, 3. What's the limit of f of xy? And so we have to imagine what happens if xy is really, really close to 2, 3. Well, when xy is really close to 2, 3, that means that x is close to 2 and y is close to 3. Well, if y is close to 3, then y squared is close to 9. And if you take a number that's close to 2 and you multiply it by a number that's close to 9, you get a number that's close to 18. So whenever xy is close to 2, 3, f of xy is close to 18. So our limit is 18. Okay, it's not a hard example. You probably just plug in the values 2 and 3 and get a number out. And that actually works because this is continuous. But a harder example would be this function. Let's consider the function f of xy is x squared minus y squared divided by x squared plus y squared. And we want to figure out the limit as xy approaches 0, 0 of this function. So let's draw a picture. See, 0, 0 is not in the domain because you'd be dividing by 0. We're going to draw some contour lines, and the contour lines look like straight lines. Whenever you're on the x-axis, that's y equals 0, f of xy is 1. So this is the contour line with side 1. Whenever you're on the y-axis, that's x equals 0, you get minus 1. Whenever you're on the 45-degree line, x equals y, well then x squared minus y squared is 0. And likewise, when x equals minus y, it's 0. So there are points really, 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 really close to the origin where the function value is 1. There are points really close to the origin where the function value is negative 1. There are points where the function value is 0, and anything in between. There's going to be a contour line here with value 1/2, contour line here with value -1/2, etc. So, since there are lots and lots and lots and lots of different values close to 0, 0, there isn't any one single limit. This limit does not exist. Okay. Last thing we want to talk about is continuous functions. We say that a function is continuous at a particular point if the limit of the function is equal to the value of the function. That's what happened with our function xy squared. So it's continuous at 2, 3, because if you plug in a number really close to 2 and a number really close to 3, you get something really close to what happens if you plug in 2 and 3. But this other function was not continuous at 0, because the limit as you approach approach the origin didn't even exist. Now, the rules about continuity and limits are essentially the same as with the single variable. Polynomials are continuous. Sine, cosine, products are continuous. Compositions of continuous things are continuous. Ratios of continuous things are continuous as long as you're not dividing by zero. The rules really are just what you've seen before. And with that, we'll stop.